Hello guys, welcome back to another Escape from Tarkov video. Today we are going to talk about some post-FX settings that I have started to use now and I'm really liking them so far. I found them on YouTube and I can link the original guy, like his video on it. But yeah, I just wanted to show this to everyone if you're like having problems seeing enemies or like, yeah, like visibility problems. You go here to post FX, enable post FX, visualize, then you can like fix it while you're in the game. And I'm gonna try like to replicate while editing like what I see versus what my recording software like picks up. Maybe I'll have to change like brightness or like could be fine, but I have mine on brightness on 0 because if you turn this up, you see it's like everything just gets, yeah, brightness. Like I would recommend to keep that on 0 or even further down depending on your monitor. Like there, you don't have to squint your eyes like as much. Saturation, I have that off because it's too much for me. It makes the game like orange and it's hard to see people like in woods, so I'll have it on 0. Clarity 70, I mean it's like changes a bit, but like it's nothing crucial, but I like to have it on 70 so it's not like too much. Colorfulness, I have it on 100. Could maybe I think I'll turn that to 90 so it's not too much. And in my Nvidia control panel, I can show you my Nvidia control panel settings before we continue. 1440p, 165Hz, but here, desktop color settings. I have the contrast on 45, and then digital vibrance. I have it on 90 here, so like 50 is the normal one, and it's so fucking... Wait, I saw now, does it not change? For me, the picture is gray. It doesn't look like it's changing on the recording. Can you see it in my face? Okay, but anyways, I have that on 90, so like when I watch YouTube and stuff like that, everything looks a lot better. Okay, and next one is Luma Sharpen. It sharpens up like mostly foliage, like trees and bushes. So I'll have mine on, had on 30. Let's go 40 maybe and try that out. Don't go too sharp with this, or at least I don't like it, because then could be pretty hard to see. Adaptive sharpen, I'll keep that off. And this is the most important one to make your game look like very nice. Here with none, not much difference, but it gets like, with this, it gets like a lot more contrast and like depth to the game. And you can like choose how much of it. The higher you go, the like darker the black gets, but like, yeah, you can see. So I usually have mine on like 50, and I can show you like here how it looks. I can go to Doorms and show you how it looks inside for like in dark rooms and stuff. And I don't know if like any specific setting in there takes up more FPS than any other. I guess like the sharpening stuff could tank your FPS a bit, so if you're struggling to get like over 60, maybe don't use that, or like just keep in mind that you could lower your FPS. And I think the clock is around like 10 o'clock in the morning and it looks like this. But yeah, let's go inside, have a look. You see, I think it's, I can show you here. This is with my settings off and then on, off, on. See, everything gets like darker, but it's like more easy to see. even though it gets dark. I don't know, it's hard to explain. It gets like, yeah, you'll have to try it out for yourself. And here we can do one more. And one more thing you can try is the colorblind mode to Tritanopia. I don't know how we say it. I have it off, but you could try it if you want. Like the green gets like really green, but then like blue things get purple. So I mean, it's a little like weird. You can see it's really green now. I don't know. I don't really like it, but you could try it out. Maybe not have it maxed, but. And like, look at this car. If we put it on off, you can see it's blue car, purple, blue, purple. So yeah, I am personally not a huge fan of that. But like I said, try it out. And I will probably like fine tune these settings myself. But like, I will probably keep it like very same to this if you're watching this like any later than when this video comes out. It is the 2nd of August right now. I changed that back to 30. I don't know. I think it's too much sharpening. Now it's good. And I thought I could try Factory 2 because it's like a pretty dark map. This is what it looks like. Daytime. Put a flashlight on. I mean, don't really need it. But yeah, if you guys like seeing these kind of like tutorial videos, leave a like for that and I'll do some more on like things you could do. And before the video ends, I'm gonna show you a mini trick. Controls. Oh, here are my controls, by the way. Show that fast. But if, when you're trying to look for extract, are you spamming O? Well, I got a nice solution for you. You take care here, check time and exits, and press that on which button you want, and then have it on release. Then all you have to do is press O, boom, nothing more. And the time and the extract comes up over one click. But yeah guys, that's it for today's video. I have a Discord server linked down below that you can join and like talk to me and maybe play with me sometime. Please like, subscribe. But yeah, I see you in the next one. Bye bye.